We're here with the Maasai Rangers, and we've got our Australian Indigenous Rangers with us.
Feel happy, you know, excited. Never been in Africa before in my life. Leave Australia in my life.
The Indigenous Ranger Exchange is an idea to have rangers from different parts of the world, from different cultures, from different ecological settings, to come together and discuss how they look after both the environment, but in tandem, their communities and culture.
I thought it would be more greener and cleaner.
Our country have a lot of water, green, always green, and not so much you don't have to be thirsty like here in Africa. My name is Stephen Andrews. I'm from Australia in Katherine region, and I come from a tribe called Jawan. I came on this trip to learn different experience in Africa. I'm with the Maasai Rangers here. This is my first time overseas. I was nervous from the start, but I got talked into it.
It's scary to leave from Perth there, a long flight, and landing in the airport and seeing people with guns and stuff, just making me more scared.
I feel privileged to be here and excited, you know, different countries, especially away from Australia for the first time. I feel a bit nervous also, you know.
So the Australian Rangers are from three different ranger groups. The Matu Desert Rangers in the Western Desert. We've got the Kimberley Rangers from northwest Western Australia.
Exhausting.
And we've also got the Jawan Rangers from the southern edge of Kakadu near Katherine. We brought an ambassador of ours and a musician friend, Dan Sultan. So a mixture of different personalities, including one amazing elder, Mookie from the Western Desert, who has brought a lot of that the elder wisdom to the trip as well.
I became a ranger because to look after my country, because our people was looking after the country long time ago.
Your mom?
Yeah, my mother.
You guys eat snakes? You can eat snake? Really?
I've seen the kind of foods that we eat is completely, totally different. Especially the snakes. No, we can't.
I'm not gonna sleep well in bed. We don't do it when it's live. We kill them first, then we bleed them.
Yeah, no.
Yeah. They should kill them first.
Yeah, I haven't liked them.
Want to try some?
Nah, I'm right.
Yeah. I look after that, all that country there.
Wow, huge, man. Do women, they hunt? Moving around looking for snakes?
Sometime.
Do they eat?
Yeah, they eat.
Even when I come back, love you.
It's really nice down here.
We're here with the biggest tusker in Africa, with the biggest mountain in Africa in the background. It's all a bit too beautiful, but it's one thing to realise that it doesn't exist without the rangers' hard work day after day, month after month. Sometimes risking their life against poachers. Just amazing.
Exciting, boys, hey? Your first elephant?
Yeah.
And a big one, too.
It's a different experience for us all, I suppose. You know, just learning about how they live, what sort of job they do.
So, on camera traps, we normally set. It will capture the poachers. We have caught many poachers there before.
They've been out in our stations where the rangers are out there for 23 days a month. Continuous, and I think that's kind of woken them up to how hard the rangers here do it.
I took a walk with the tree ranger, good little walk, pull the sweat out and get the leg bit shaken up there. The ranger work here, it's a little bit same, but in their work they got a lot of walking, and a bit scary, you know, they got dangerous animal.
Early this morning they found a poacher on the side of the road heading towards our way, and they're just having a few questions with him.
This guy looks like he's from Tanzania. He hasn't yet told me, but he sounds like a Tanzanian accent. Might be a poacher, maybe. Yeah, I'm here to confirm.
Scary for us, because we don't get like poachers like this back at home. With the drama.
Watching Stephen and Virgil, Stephen was probably one of the first guys to really be proactive on this trip. Together they've come forward, and the whole group's actually come forward and really participating strongly.
He was nervous, seeing different people. Yeah, I was frightened. Now, he's changed. There was a good people in Africa.
It really feel really like, you know, this really small world. I mean, like, you know, just bringing the rangers from Australia all the way down to Kenya, you know, Aborigines and Maasai together, rangers.
Maybe next time we come back, we might bring a kangaroo back.
Then you know that it's time to get moving. I've been away. I've been blinded. I've been away. Oh, yeah. Oh.
I really am impressed with how much they've taken from this trip, and they're actually asking themselves more questions, which is great too. And they said, well, when I go home, I've got to speak to the elders about knowing more about my culture, so I can, when I come back next time, I can say more. So that's the idea, and so it's embracing culture and conservation in the one.
Yeah.